प्रोफेसर जोशी बीएम फ्रॉम अर्जुन टेक्निकल कैंपस चास अहमदनगर. टुडेज लेक्चर वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज थ्री फेज ट्रांसफार्मर. थ्री फेज ट्रांसफार्मर. Previous lecture we have discussed about a single phase transformer. We know that the range of the single phase transformer is that its life is lies between the 0 to 232 to 40 volt. The single phase voltage is lies between 0 to 232 to 40 and having only two windings. One is primary and another is secondary winding. Okay, single phase having two windings, one is a primary and another is secondary, while the voltage range of the three phase transformer is lies between 0 to 40 volt. Okay. In this lecture, we have to discuss about a three-phase transformer. Generally, the electrical power is generated in the form of three-phase voltage, and the distribution is also in the form of three-phase voltage. Okay, so the generated power. Generated power is in the form of three phase, and it is also transmitted in the form of three phase. It means it is generated in three phase and also transmitted in three phase. Because of that, we have to use three phase transformer. Okay, so so the generated electrical power in the range in between the range 32.2 kilovolt to 22 kilovolt. Okay, the generated range is 13.2 kilovolt to 22 kilovolt. We know that the basic application or the basic reason of the transformer is transformer rises the voltage level or decreases the voltage level. For the substation or the distribution purpose, we have to increase the voltage level up to 132 kilovolt or 400 kilovolt. For the transmission purpose, we have to increase the voltage level up to the 132 kilovolt or 400 volt. For the distribution purpose, or the basic consumer, we require the voltage level is 400 volt for three phase and 230 or 240 volt for the single phase. Okay, to increase the voltage level or to decrease the voltage level, we required a transformer, because a transformer is a device which convert the electrical power from one alternating circuit to another alternating circuit with desired changes in output, that is changes in current or in voltage, but it doesn't change in frequency. So to convert the electrical power, that is three phase electrical power, from one alternating circuit to another alternating circuit, we require a three-phase transformer. So it is necessary to set up a transformer to increase voltage level from 13.2 kilovolt to 22 kilovolt or the desired level. Three-phase transformer are used for the that purpose or the same purpose. Okay, but in early days, instead of the three-phase transformer, we use a combination of three single phase transformer. We use three single phase transformer are connected in such that three phase winding are connected in delta or star fashion. Okay, that means instead of the one single unit of three phase transformer, we use a three units of single phase transformer instead of a single unit. Okay, now we have to draw here a diagram of three phase transformer. Okay, for that I draw here three single units of transformer . So I draw here three single units. This transformer is named as T1, this transformer is named as T2, and this transformer is named as T3. I draw here three single units. So first of all, we have to connect this with last. Okay, this with the last. And after the second this is our Y and this is our B, RY B. So this fashion means this transformer is connected in delta format. Okay, this is in the delta format. Okay, this is our R. After that, this is our Y, and this is our B, and the last one is our neutral point. That means this connection is star connected and this is our delta connected point. Okay, in this we observe here, this is our transformer T, this is T2, this is T3. That means here three single units of single phase transformer we consider in for that. The first terminal of the first transformer is connected to the second terminal of third transformer. After that, second terminal of first transformer is connected to the first terminal of second transformer, and second terminal of second transformer is connected to the first terminal of third transformer. That this fashion is called as a delta connection. Okay, that means it forms like a triangle. Okay, this forms like a triangle type of winding. Because of that, we call it as a delta fashion. So, in case of secondary winding, here what we have to do, the second terminal of first transformer is connected to the second terminal of third transformer, while the second terminal of second transformer is connected to the second terminal of second transformer, and first terminal is kept open. Okay, after that here we kept the first terminal of third transformer also kept open. That means this fashion of the winding is star connected winding with a neutral connection. Okay, with neutral connection. In this transformer we observe star as well as delta winding. Delta winding is connected in, for the primary side, while secondary side is connected with the star winding. Okay, I also draw here star delta type of winding, so you understand easily. Can understand easily. For that I have to draw here. This is our star delta winding with delta connection. This is our neutral connection. So here this is our R, this is a Y, and this is a Y, and last one is R Y B. Y, this is the R, this is Y and B. This is our primary side, whereas this is the secondary side with the neutral winding. Okay, this like this fashion we can connect a three single units of a three transformer and make it as a three phase transformer. Okay, so the three phase transformer, the back of three transformer having some major applications compared to the single unit of three phase transformer. The applications are that the first application is the reliability. Reliability is good. The reliability of three phase, three single unit of three phase transformer is very good as compared to single unit of three phase transformer. And the second application is that the cost is cheaper in cost. Cheaper in cost and the cheaper to carry and cheaper to carry spare parts. Cheaper to carry spare parts. After that, the third advantages is that in case of mines or underground uses, this type of transformer, that means three single unit of transformer, is preferred because in case of maintenance we can replace easily a single unit of transformer. And the last application is that
The last application is that
if any one unit becomes faulty, if the any one unit of three single unit of transformer becomes faulty without interrupting the device or without interrupting the operation by connecting this transformer in open delta connection, we can replace the another unit easily. Or if any one transformer is inoperative, in case of bank of three phase transformer, that unit can be replaced easily or by made the connection open delta connection, we can use this transformer easily. Okay, this is a general introduction of three phase transformer.